Well, the big story of the day, the Adani Group has vehemently rejected the latest allegations made by the U.S. short seller Hindenburg in its report. The report had cited alleged whistleblower documents and had claimed that the SEBI chief, Madhavi Buch, and her husband have stakes in obscure offshore entities with links to companies related to the Adani scandal.
Now, the Adani Group, in its detailed statement, has called these charges a red herring by a desperate entity which has blatant disregard for Indian laws. Madhavi Puri Buch and her husband Dhaval Buch have also released a joint statement rejecting the charges by Hindenburg report. Meanwhile, BJP too has reacted to the latest report, raising questions over the timing of this report.
In fact, BJP Sudhanshu Trivedi says that each time the parliament session gets underway, a foreign group releases a report which the opposition then latches on to create anarchy in the country.
Bharat ki jaanch एजेंसियों में से का जांच का सामना कर रही एक कंपनी हिंडनबर्ग के द्वारा सात समंदर पार से एक सुर उठाया जाता है और सारा विपक्ष उसमें ताल मिलाने लगता है, और उससे भी अधिक गंभीर बात यह है कि वो संसद सत्र के साथ उसका संबंध जोड़ देते हैं। मैं पूछना चाहता हूं विपक्ष से कि इसका अर्थ यह हुआ कि आप ये याद करिए, बीबीसी की डॉक्यूमेंट्री संसद सत्र शुरू होने से ठीक पहले आई थी, जनवरी में हिंडनबर्ग की रिपोर्ट बजट सत्र शुरू होने से ठीक पहले आई थी। सारे सीक्वेंस जाके देख लीजिएगा, संसद सत्र के दौरान ही आते हैं। और आज बरबस विपक्ष ने जब संसद सत्र का विषय उठाया तो यह और साफ हो गया कि इसका मतलब यह संदेह बहुत गहरा हो जाता है कि सीमा पार से विपक्ष के कुछ ऐसे तार जुड़े हुए हैं कि भारत के हर संसद सत्र के दौरान एक अव्यवस्था का वातावरण उत्पन्न किया जाए।
हिंडनबर्ग और विषय तो सोल रहा है, கண்டிப்பாக ஆராய வேண்டியது நம்ம கடமை. அவங்க நல்லவங்களா கெட்டவங்களா நம்ம பார்க்கக்கூடாது. இடன்பாக் சொல்லியிருக்கிறாங்க, அதுபோல் 1000 பேர் சொல்கிறாங்க இந்த செபியினுடைய தலைவராக இருக்கக்கூடியவருக்கு ஆஃப் ஷோர் அக்கௌண்ட்டில் வந்து ஏதோ சம்மந்தம் இருக்குங்கிறாங்க. அது கண்டிப்பாக கண்டறியப்பட வேண்டியது தான். ஆனால் இதற்கு முறை நாம் நல்லா புரிஞ்சுக்கணும், இடன்பாக் அவங்க புலி வருது புலி வருதுன்னு பல முறை புலி வருது புலி வருதுன்னு சொல்லி கழுது புலி கூட வரல. நாமளும் புலி வருது புலி வருதுன்னு 3 மாசமாக திரும்பி பார்த்தோம். இடன்பாக்ல சொல்லிட்டோம் அதானி புலி வருதா அம்பானி புலி வருதான்னு பார்த்தோம், ஒரு கழுது புலியை கூட காணாம். ஆனால் இந்த முறை மறுபடியும் செபி புலி வந்திருக்குன்னு கிளம்பியிருக்கு, அதையும் இன்வெஸ்டிகேட் பண்ணுவோம். அரசுங்கிறது என்னங்கண்ணா, பார்க்காம இருக்கக்கூடாதல்ல.
Annamalai has called for probe, which has been welcomed by the Congress, by upping the ante against Rahul Gandhi.
Now, the leader of opposition in Lok Sabha, the Congress MP, has also said that the integrity of SEBI has been gravely compromised by the allegations against its chairperson. He also has asked 3 questions based on the allegations in the latest report. Rahul Gandhi asking why hasn't the SEBI chairperson resigned yet if there are such allegations against her.
He also asked if investors lose their hard-earned money, who will be held accountable. He asked, in light of new and serious allegations, will Supreme Court now take suo motu cognizance? Congress President Mallikarjun Kharge has revived the demand for a JPC investigation into Hindenburg allegations against the Adani Group.
This is an explosive allegation because it alleges that the umpire herself is compromised. The savings of millions of Indians, hard-earned, honestly earned savings, are at risk. It is therefore imperative that this matter is investigated. Retail investors, honest investors, pensioners have 3 questions. The first, why has Chairperson Madhavi Buch not resigned? Second, God forbid something were to go wrong and investors were to lose their money, who is responsible? Is the Prime Minister of India responsible? Is Madhavi Buch responsible? Or is Mr. Adani responsible? And finally, the Supreme Court has been looking at this matter. New allegations have emerged. Very serious, explosive allegations have emerged. Is the Supreme Court going to look at this matter suo motu again? Slowly becoming crystal clear why Prime Minister Modi is against a joint parliamentary committee looking into this matter.
Now, the BJP has strongly condemned Rahul Gandhi's remarks while asking, is he indirectly supporting Hindenburg? That's the attack that has come in from the BJP. The BJP questioning Rahul Gandhi's statement, asking if he is supporting Hindenburg.
Well, multiple reactions, in fact, and we have several tweets here of the BJP leaders. Let's begin with Amit Malviya. Amit Malviya, they're taking a direct jibe and a sharp attack on Rahul Gandhi. Amit Malviya says, and I quote, "This post confirms that Balak Buddhi Rahul Gandhi has gone rogue. The leader of opposition is now openly inciting and seeding doubt about the genuineness of the Indian stock markets. This blatant attempt to undermine confidence in our economy reveals true intention of Rahul Gandhi, which is nothing but destruction of India. All this comes despite the previous so-called expose of Adani by Hindenburg turning out to be a damn squib. The expert committee appointed by the Supreme Court concluded there was no regulatory failure regarding the allegations of price manipulation. On January 3, 2024, the Supreme Court, led by CJI D.Y. Chandrachud, observed that no willful or deliberate violations were done by SEBI. It is now in public domain that Anla Cheng and her husband Mark Kingdon hired Hindenburg to manipulate markets and profit millions at the cost of erasing significant market value with no remorse. Their scheme, designed to advance Chinese strategic interests, deliberately undermine an Indian corporate giant that had outshined Chinese firms in crucial international ventures. Curiously, these actions align with the Congress Party's clandestine memorandum of understanding with the CPC. The full extent of this deception was revealed in a sworn statement by Shannon Van Sant, a former employee of Cheng's company, Sub China, before the US. So Amit Malviya is hitting out at Rahul Gandhi. We also have a tweet by Shehzad Poonawalla. Shehzad Poonawalla is explaining the equation. He says, here is the equation. If stock market falls tomorrow due to panic based on complete lies, Indian investors will lose money. Hindenburg will make money. Guess which side Rahul Gandhi is batting for? Why do you think he wants Hindenburg to make money? So multiple reactions coming in, Pratibha, from the BJP leaders, all of them hitting out at Rahul Gandhi, saying you're creating doubt in the mind of the investors against the Indian stock market.
Okay, all right. So that's a reaction coming in. The politics around it continues. The Congress Party, remember, has now said that there should be a probe. The other opposition MPs from the India bloc, like the TMC MP Mahua Moitra, also calling this the Adani-style crony capitalism at its best. In fact, she's also calling for the immediate resignation of the SEBI chief Madhabi Buch. The left leaders are also raising questions over the conflict of interest and are alleging a cover-up by SEBI. The other allies of the India bloc, like the Aadmi Party, the RJD and the Shiv Sena UBT, want the Supreme Court to reopen the case and form an SIT to look into the allegations.
Madam Madhabi Puri, in 2015, you had invested into this very FBI that you now claim that you have no idea about the ultimate ownership. In 2018, you had personally corresponded with this particular fund on your own, in your own personal capacity. When the inquiry report started in 23-24, should you not have disclosed this? Should you not have recused yourself? And how could you possibly say that you know nothing about this fund? How can this SEBI summon an overseas fund, Hindenburg, when it is completely ignoring the role of the FPIs? We demand the immediate resignation of Madhavi Puri Butch as chairperson of SEBI, and we demand that the Supreme Court reopen an investigation into this, and the Supreme Court appoint an SIT to look into this with no delay.
Madhavi Butch ne kyun nahi bataya ki hujur main jaanch nahi kar sakti kyunki hamara mamla hamara paisa to aur hamare pati ka paisa to khud hi in funds ke upar laga hua hai जिसको विनोद अडानी मैनेज करता है, जेपीसी से इसकी जांच कराओ। और तब मेरी एक नहीं सुनी गई, बल्कि उल्टा मोदी जी ने उठा के हमको जेल में भेज दिया।
And amid the war of words, SEBI has issued a statement. Let's take you through the key takeaways of that statement released by SEBI. This is what SEBI says. Top court noted that SEBI finished 22 out of 24 investigations. They're talking about the investigations that are underway. More than 100 summons, around 1,100 letters have been issued. These are statements in wake of the fresh allegations. More than 100 communications made seeking assistance. These are some key takeaways from the statement released by SEBI. More than 300 documents with 12,000 pages have been examined so far. So SEBI statement talks about the scrutiny which is taking place, the investigation which is underway. SEBI initiated enforcement proceedings after its probe. So SEBI is taking multiple actions when it comes to investigation. Show cause notice was issued, giving opportunity of hearing. Apart from that, SEBI is also highlighting appropriate appropriate actions are being taken in accordance with law. So in a way, giving an assurance that the investigation is taking place in a fair manner, SEBI has internal mechanisms to address conflict of interest. So if there is a conflict of interest, SEBI has internal mechanisms to deal with it. Chairperson has recused herself in matters that involve conflict. So these are the key takeaways from the SEBI statement. We have some breaking inputs coming in as well.